massively beautiful day, a gift from God to be here this morning for our priests to renew their promises, for our church to be gathered together to bless and consecrate these oils that will be used throughout the diocese. We place ourselves under the protection of Almighty God. We ask for His grace. We open our hearts to His love as it pours forth into us through the power of the Holy Spirit. As we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring glad tidings to the lowly, to heal the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of vindication by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness in place of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a listless spirit. You yourselves shall be named priests of the Lord, ministers of our God, you shall be called. I will give them their recompense faithfully, a lasting covenant I will make with them. Their descendants shall be renowned among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge them as a race the Lord has blessed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
from the book of Revelation. Grace to you and peace from Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead and ruler of the kings of the earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, who has made us into a kingdom, priests for his God and Father, to him be glory and power forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming amid the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. All the peoples of the earth will lament him. Yes, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, the one who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty, the Word of the Lord.
Because he has anointed me to bring glad tidings to the poor.
He has sent me to proclaim liberty to captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to let the oppressed go free, and to proclaim a year acceptable to the Lord. Rolling up the scroll, he handed it back to the attendant and sat down. And the eyes of all in the synagogue looked intently at him. He said to them, "Today, this scripture passage is fulfilled in your hearing." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I did not play priest growing up.
Others discern their vocation much later in life, after they had jobs. Perhaps a few like me debated this call from God, pointing out that he must be crazy. And if he were all-knowing, he would know not to call me. As you can tell, God won the debate with each of us who are priests. Even as some of us protested, "Not me, Lord," but in the end, all of us said, "Thy will be done." As I'm now privileged to travel about the great diocese of Greensburg, I am extremely proud of our priests. Not that we don't have a few quirks here and there. Oh, yes, we do. I know I do. People write me about them all the time. But imperfect men, myself included, said yes to God's call when others said no to it. And ultimately, we opened ourselves up to the power of his voice that said to us, "I choose you." And then what can we do? In a few minutes, we will renew our priestly promises and rekindle the memories of our ordination day, which was filled with great memories. To our priests here, I want to say thank you, gentlemen, for your yes. I appreciate it. We all do.
What a purpose
Each of us is both called and at the same time undeserving of the call to be disciples of Jesus Christ as we sit at his feet to learn from the Master's life. Just as each priest was called to priesthood, each of us was called to be Christian. It was a call. A call to seek holiness, to strive for the greater things, and to listen to God's Son saying to us, follow me. Follow me. Whatever I ask you to do, just follow me. This is a journey that began long ago when we were baptized and lifted up out of the baptismal pool to be presented to the world as God's Son or God's daughter. If we really knew who we were and how special we were, I am a son of God. You're a son of God, a daughter of God, by adoption, through baptism. Jesus, crucified and risen from the dead, has a vision for the church that he built on Peter's faith. And we are asked to carry out the vision of Christ in all that we do here in the Diocese of Greensburg. Jesus has a vision for us, for this church. In fact, we want to make his vision come alive for ourselves, for our families, in our parishes, and in our communities. And this takes great trust in God and a willingness to change in order to make the Lord's vision become our vision. Not my will, but his be done. What is the vision that Christ gives to us? He announced it in that synagogue long ago when he made his ministry public. It includes lifting up the poor, giving liberty to help to those who are held captive by their sins. His vision includes giving the light of faith to those who are blind to the presence of God and cannot see him. We have to give light to these people. And proclaiming God's love in a year of favor that never ends. His vision includes a church where we love God above anything else and our neighbors as ourselves. Where even the stranger is welcomed, especially those who are seeking safe shelter and a better life for themselves and their families. It includes a world where every human life is seen as a gift from God, protected and valued, whether still in the womb or at the moment of death, and where we see all of this, all of God's creation, as a gift, and use it well. The world Jesus sees and what he wants for our church is a place where we can forgive so that we can be forgiven, where we do not walk on the other side of the road, but rather go out of our way to pick up the person left beaten by the side of it. Jesus has this vision where we welcome sinners and seek out the lost. In the words of Pope Francis, our church must have leaders who smell like the sheep they serve. And sometime at the end of the day, I'm pretty smelly. And all of us in this great living body of the church must be ready to go out to the peripheries of the world, as Pope Francis says it, to those places where people are addicted to drugs, or frightened by the violence and terrorism that surrounds them, or are simply lost in the confusion of our secular age. We are called to do this by the vision of Jesus, not because we are so good or special, but because he is so good and so special. He is God's only Son. And God said to us, listen to him. Listen to him. His vision includes baptizing and teaching and feeding and healing and sacrificing and worshiping and giving thanks and everything. His vision includes having a relationship with each of us where he knows us and we know him in a real and personal way. In a way where he is not just up there, but also in here in our hearts. Where we can talk to him as if we were talking to the person next to us. Because he is even closer to us than that. If we make this vision our own, our church would be doing really well. If we make this vision our own, then we come to know that every blessing we have comes to us from God, and He wants us to share what He has given to us for the good of all of us. He gives me certain gifts, not to be kept to myself, but to be used. And He gives each of you certain gifts, not to be kept to yourself, but to be used for bringing about His vision. The vision of Christ for the church includes, dare we say it, that we be like Christ ourselves. When we become like Christ, we have seen the vision. This is where I want to come to the heart of this Chrism Mass, which is, after all, about the blessing and consecrating of these oils that are God's gift to us. Oil has a way of spreading out and seeping in. I know this every time I spill some on my counter. Spreads out, seeps in. This oil will be spread out from this cathedral to our parishes and our ministries throughout the Diocese of Greensburg. The oil of Chrism will seep into the lives of newborn infants when they're baptized, as well as those adults who will be born again soon at the Easter Vigil. It will spread out from here to all those who are to be confirmed. It will seep into their souls and indelibly mark them as people anointed and empowered to proclaim the good news of Jesus. Because each of us has been confirmed, has been given that task, anointed to proclaim good news. This oil will be spread onto the hands and seep into the life of Brother Canice McMullen, the Benedictine monk who I will ordain to the priesthood, please God, about 5 weeks from now. And the same oil of Chrism will seep into the altar that I will dedicate in a few months at Holy Family Church in La Trobe. Chrism signifies the Holy Spirit that seeps into our lives and becomes one with us as Christian believers. The Holy Spirit poured into us, seeping into our soul, reminding us who Jesus is, what He wants from us, and what He did for us. It reminds us of our sacred calling to be Christian. The oil of the sick will flow from this cathedral throughout the diocese to give God's grace to our infirmed. And at the end of life's journey, this oil of the sick will be used to massage God's soothing ointment of care into those who will soon depart from this earth. Whatever our calling in life, God gives us everything we need to fulfill His vision and build up His kingdom. Today, in the oils that we will bless and consecrate, we celebrate the abundance of God's help. All of us is being consecrated and blessed to help us through the gift of God. You, me, our priests, are called together to be a blessing for each other. We give thanks to God for His abundant generosity to us as a church. We give thanks for His Son who died to take away our sins. We give thanks for His resurrection, for He lives among us, alive and present to us here and now. In response, we pledge ourselves to be His priests and His people, to unite ourselves to Him in faith and in love. And we promise that we will not let this precious oil and our own sacred calling go to waste. We will not waste what He has given to us. We will not waste our calling as Christian, as married, as priest, as consecrated, as single. May we be good stewards of Jesus and good stewards of His abundant blessing to us. Because folks, when you leave here today, I want you to know one thing. We're blessed. We are blessed by a God who loves us. Those are our needs, those are our troubles. And sends Jesus to give us the comfort of his anointing. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you.
Because by the holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Amen. Beloved sons, on the anniversary of that day when Christ our Lord conferred his priesthood on his apostles and on us, are you resolved to renew in the presence of your bishop and God's holy people the promises you once made? Are you resolved to be more united with the Lord Jesus and more closely conformed to him, denying yourselves and confirming those promises about sacred duties towards Christ's church, which prompted by love of him, you willingly and joyfully pledge on the day of your priestly ordination?
Amen.
Are you resolved to be faithful stewards of the mysteries of God in the Holy Eucharist and the other liturgical rites, and to discharge faithfully the sacred office of teaching, following Christ the head and shepherd, not seeking any gain, but moved only by zeal for souls? As for you, dear sons and daughters, pray for your priests, that the Lord may pour out his gifts abundantly upon them and keep them faithful as ministers of Christ, the High Priest, so that they may lead you to him who is the source of salvation.
Christ hear us. Christ graciously hear us.
And pray also for me, that I may be faithful to the apostolic office entrusted to me in my lowliness, and that in your midst I may be made day by day a living and more perfect image of Christ, the priest, the good shepherd, the teacher, and the servant of all.
Christ hear us. Christ graciously hear us.
May the Lord keep us all in his charity and lead all of us, shepherds and flock, to eternal life.
Amen.
Thank you. the oil of the sick. God of all consolation, you chose and sent your Son to heal the world. Graciously listen to our prayer of faith. Send the power of your Holy Spirit, the Consoler, into this precious oil, this soothing ointment, this rich gift, this fruit of the earth. Bless this oil and sanctify it for our use. Make this oil a remedy for all who are anointed with it. Heal them in body, in soul, and in spirit, and deliver them in every affliction. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord God, protector of all who believe in you, bless this oil and give wisdom and strength to all who are anointed with it in preparation for their baptism. Bring them to a deeper understanding of the gospel. Help them to accept the challenge of Christian living and lead them to the joy of new birth in the family of your church through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray to God, our Almighty Father, will bless this oil so that all who are anointed with it may be inwardly transformed and come to share in eternal salvation. God, our Maker, source of all growth and holiness, accept the joyful thanks and praise we offer in the name of your church. In the beginning, at your command, the earth produced fruit-bearing trees. From the fruit of the olive tree, you have provided us with oil for holy Christmas. The prophet David sang of the life and joy that the oil would bring us in the sacraments of your love. After the avenging flood, the dove returned to Noah with an olive branch, announced your gift of peace. This was a sign of the greater gift to come. Now the waters of baptism wash away the sins of men, and by the anointing with olive oil you make us radiant with your joy. At your command, Aaron was washed with water, and your servant Moses, his brother, anointed him priest. Thus too, this too foreshadowed greater things to come. After your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, asked John for baptism in the waters of the Jordan, you sent the Spirit upon him in the form of a dove, and by the witness of your own voice, you declared him to be your only well-beloved Son. In this you clearly fulfilled the prophecy of David, that Christ would be anointed with the oil of gladness beyond his fellow men. And so, Father, we ask you to bless this oil you have created. Fill it with the power of your Holy Spirit through Christ your Son. It is from him that chrism takes its name, and with chrism you have anointed for yourself priests and kings, prophets and martyrs. Make this chrism a sign of life and salvation for those who are to be born again in the waters of baptism. Wash away the evil they have inherited from sinful Adam. And when they are anointed with this holy oil, make them temples of your glory, radiant with the goodness of life that has its source in you. Through this sign of chrism, grant them royal, priestly, and prophetic honor, and clothe them with incorruption. Let this be indeed the chrism of salvation for those who will be born again of water and the Holy Spirit. May they come to share eternal life in the glory of your kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of all the church.
May the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, mercifully wipe away what is old in us and increase in us grace of salvation and newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant, and by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the Church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses them to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the Paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with the word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you, and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself, and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim.
Catholic and apostolic faith.
devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, for they offer it for themselves, and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, the King.
In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon and Jude, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Posadius, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things you may be defended by your protecting God.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands. And once more, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The minister we have thanked. Sacrifice our spotless victims. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar of God, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Bless also your servants, who those sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your protection through Christ our Lord,
through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.